Welcome back to the Keaton Knife Shop. Today we're going to be reviewing the SRG 2x72-inch belt grinder manufactured by Kyle Adrmas. This is an entry-level 2x72 grinder that without a doubt was designed for new knife makers who are on a budget. I was lucky enough to acquire this belt sander secondhand. However, it can be bought without the motor and VFD for around $500 from Kyle's site. I purchased a chassis, motor, and VFD together secondhand. Mine has a 1-horsepower motor, a KB electronics variable frequency drive, and a 6-inch drive wheel. All in all, if you're purchasing new, you should be able to expect a price tag all in of around $1,000 to $1,200. To cheapen it up a little bit, you could utilize a motor with a pulley system instead of using a VFD. However, after having a chance to use the VFD, I don't think I'd be able to go back. I say this because the variable C drive has come in real handy for me, specifically for grinding plunges and handle materials. Being able to slow down lessens the amount of mistakes that so frequently can happen at high speeds, like burning your handle materials when you're dealing with micarta. Alrighty, before we get into the nitty-gritty, look at the bottom right-hand corner of your screen and nail that subscribe and the bell button so that you'll get more reviews and knife-related videos in your feed in the future. Let's go over the features of the SRG 2x72 belt sander. We'll start off with the tensioning arm. I found the tensioning arm to be very user-friendly. It's easy to engage and disengage, and it holds a very suitable tension on the belt. Having a decent amount of tension on the belt has helped me with slack belt grinding, and I've heard of these shocks having issues versus springs, but I haven't noticed any problems, so thumbs up on the belt tensioner. Before we go any further, please notice that my SRG model has a 1.5 by 3/4 inch tooling arm. This was something that I was initially worried about since most tooling arms on larger grinders are 1.5 by 1.5. However, it has not been an issue thus far. One advantage of the smaller tooling arms is that everything is lighter, so moving around the tools is easier. If you want to convert this machine to 1.5 by 1.5, you can do that with this belt grinder. You'll need to loosen these two bolts and add some spacers, but it's doable. Next, we're on to the tracking knob. It's located below the tensioning handle. At first, I had a hard time with it, however, it was due to user error. After I oiled it up with some WD-40, it moves effortlessly. Tracking in general on this machine has been great. It seems to be highly dependent on the belt, however. The cork belts that you'll see here seem to be wobbling some, but my J-Flex, ceramic, and gator belts are all solid. The two-wheel platen that came with the machine has a mild steel face. I have a whole video on how to install a ceramic glass platen that I'll put in the cards above. But this platen has been a great performer. It has two 2-inch idler wheels and has done a great job thus far. I did have to notch the back end of the plate face so that I can make it 100% parallel with the belts. So I slotted one of the two connecting bolts so that I can move it back and forth and line it up perfectly with the belts. But that was no big deal. The work rest that came with the grinder could have been better. It seems fairly cheap in comparison to the rest of the grinder, and I have issues with getting it squared to the platen face horizontally. And overall, adjusting it is difficult. I'll eventually build my own work rest, so this isn't a large negative. However, it would have been nice if this work rest was a little more stout. One interesting thing about this grinder is that it came with little rubber feet on it. I think these were instituted on the machine so that it would be more mobile. I've operated it for months with the rubber feet on it while still being bolted down to my stand, and it's worked out pretty well. I recently removed the feet and have the grinder sitting on some wooden blocks now. I believe it's slightly reduced vibration. Speaking of vibration, for only having a 3/4 inch by 1.5 inch tooling arm, I think the vibration is very manageable on this machine. I don't have a lot to compare this to, however, this is the grinder running at 80% power. The gentleman who owned this grinder before me had a 4-inch contact wheel for it. I've used it for some odd jobs and also for rough profiling to save my platen face the headache. I think he used it for scandy grinding, but I have not fully utilized this tool yet. I noted earlier that I have a 1-horsepower Leeson brushless motor on this belt sander. I read a good deal about how 1-horsepower is underpowered, however, it hasn't been an issue for me. I'm able to do everything that I want to do with this machine without bogging it down. I could imagine if I did more tapered tangs, or if I was a more aggressive rough profiler on this machine, that I could present itself as an issue. But the 1-horsepower has been working great for me. The last tool I have for this belt grinder is the Origin Blade Maker small wheel attachment. My wonderful wife got me this for my birthday present this year, and I ordered the tooling arm raw stock from an online aluminum supplier. After some more months with this attachment, I plan on doing a dedicated review. Throughout this review, I've tried to demonstrate this grinder in action. I've ground high carbon steel both pre and post heat treat with this machine, as well as wood, synthetics, brass, stainless steel, kydex, and aluminum. The 2x72 grinder, in general, is a workhorse for any shop. You'll be surprised with the strange task you find for it. Good belt tension and tracking, and a good flat parallel platen has greatly improved my plunges and bevels. By utilizing more specialized belts, like gator belts and cork belts, I've been able to lessen my hand sanding time substantially. This SRG grinder from Kyle Adrmas seems to live up to its desired intention, which is a low-cost budget 2x72 grinder. For me, it was a major step forward from the 2x42 that I had before. Being able to control the speed of the grinder and having a large selection of high-end, commonly available 2x72 belts was a game-changer. I've also noticed that with the longer belts and the VFD, the heat issues that I encountered with my smaller 2x42 are non-existent. If any of you have specific questions, I'll do my best to answer them in the comment section below. If you found this review useful, please hit that like and subscribe button. And until the next time, I'll catch you guys on the flip side.